what is atomic scattering amplitude or atomic scattering factor? It is ratio of, or we can say it is scattering power of an atom with respect to scattering power of an electron. Now total scattering amplitude or total scattering factor, that is denoted by capital F, and is equal to scattering power of a unit cell with respect to scattering power of an electron. Now you know unit cell has number of atoms, like in simple cubic number of atoms are 1 for B.Sc, 2 for F.Sc, 4. So that means capital F is scattering power of unit cell, and that contains number of atoms. So ratio of, next is geometrical structure factor, and it is denoted by capital S, and is equal to ratio of the total scattering power, total scattering amplitude to the atomic scattering amplitude. Ratio of total scattering amplitude to the atomic scattering amplitude. And you know, total scattering amplitude is number of atoms per unit cell multiplied by scattering power of one atom with respect to electron. So that means it is Z into F. Capital F is Z into F. That means generally it is equal to Z. That means for simple cubic it should be 1. For B.Sc it should be 2. For F.Sc it should be 4. But it can be different depending upon the question. Who will answer it? But it's called geometrically. This is capital S. Now, what is the significance of this capital S? Case one: if capital S is equal to 0, that means orbital reflection. Orbital, you know, not allowed. Reflection is not allowed. Or we can say missing reflection, or the what do you call it? Extinction. Extinct. पता है ना आपको? जो खत्म हो जाते हैं जैसे dinosaur. Dinosaur क्या है? Extinct हो गए ना? है ना? वहाँ से ये word. Yes. वहाँ से ये word है extinction. ठीक है? तो if capital S is not equal to 0. That means allowed reflection. No, intensity of radiation I is proportional to total scattering amplitude raised to power 2. So intensity of radiation I is proportional to total scattering amplitude raised to power 2. That means if capital S is 0, that means capital F is also 0. Capital I 0. That's why it is known as forbidden reflection. In this case, if capital S is not 0, capital F is not 0, I is also not equal to 0. Consider a simple cubic unit cell of an atom containing 3 electrons. Means that atom has 3 electrons. Okay? Or scattering power of single electron is 5 units. Then we have to calculate atomic structure amplitude. So pehle hum ye nikale. Okay? First point. Kya nikalna? Small f. Atomic structure amplitude. Now, for atomic structure amplitude, it is scattering power of atom divided by scattering power of electron. Now, scattering power of atom is not given, but number of electrons in the atom are given. 3 electrons, and scattering of power of per electron is 5. So, total scattering power of the atom is 3 into 5. And scattering power of single electron is 5. That means it comes out to be 3. Right? Now, capital F. Capital F is scattering power of unit cell to the scattering power of electron. So, now scattering power of unit cell. So, we have to calculate first number of atoms per unit cell into scattering power of single atom divided by scattering power of electron. Now, how many atoms are there per unit cell? One, because it is simple cubic. So, number of atom is 1. And what is scattering power of single atom? 3 into 5. 3 into 5. And scattering power of electron? 5. Again it is 3. Okay, now third point is geometrical structure factor, and geometrical structure factor, that is S, is equal to total scattering amplitude to the atomic scattering amplitude, and that is 3 divided by 3, means it is 1. S comes out to be 1. And last question is intensity of radiation, and that is equal to F raised to power 2. And what is F? 3. So 3 raised to power 2 means 9. So this is the values of, these are the values of small F, capital F, capital S and capital I. Same question, geometrical structure factor. Now geometrical structure factor nikale ke apne kya tha? Total scattering amplitude to the atomic scattering amplitude. Ab question aisa ho ki total scattering amplitude, atomic structure amplitude are not given. Theek hai? Coordinates are given. Coordinates, angular indices of a plane are given. Then formula is e raised to power 2 pi iota. Iota you know, under root minus 1. X j h y j k plus z j l. This is the formula. What are x, y, j and z? They are coordinates. H, k, h, k, l. Are Miller indices, iota, under root minus 1, that means iota square is equal to minus 1, ठीक है, क्या बोलते हैं iota को यहाँ, k, एमएससी का आई भी होता है ना। इमेजिनरी नंबर के लिए a प्लस आयोटा भी होता ना, इमेजिनरी नंबर्स होते। ओके, अब ये कैलकुलेट कैपिटल S फॉर सिंपल क्यूबिक यूनिट्स एंड व्हाट आर द वैल्यूज ऑफ H, K एंड L फॉर अलाउड रिफ्लेक्शन और अलाउड रिफ्लेक्शन कब होती है? व्हेन कैपिटल एस इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो। ठीक है, तो ऐसी एच के एल की वैल्यूज वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट फॉर विच एस इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, राइट। अभी सिंपल क्यूबिक में व्हाट आर द कोऑर्डिनेट्स? That is one. Number of atoms per unit cell is equal to one, but coordinates are 0, 0, 0, 0. X, J, Y, J, and Z, J. That is equal to 0, 0, 0. These are the coordinates of simple cubic unit cell. Well, atom in the simple cubic unit cell. Just put the value. कैपिटल एस इज इक्वल टू ई रेज टू पार 2 बाई एटा 0 इंटू एच 0 इंटू के 0 इंटू एल 0, तो ई रेज टू पार 0, दैट मीन इट इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू 1 फॉर सिंपल क्यूबिक। एस इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू 1 और वी कैन से एस कैन नेवर कैन नॉट इक्वल टू 0 फॉर सिंपल क्यूबिक unit cell. So in this case reflections are allowed for all possible values of H, K and L. For simple cubic unit cell, there are allowed reflections for any value of H, K, L. Okay? Second, S for B.Sc. Body centered unit cell. What is value of Z? Capital S for body centered cubic unit cell. So Z is 2 and coordinates are 0, 0, 0 and half, half, half. For first particle and second, it is half, half, half. Okay? So it is actually summation of XGH, YJ, K plus ZJ. For simple cubic, first case 0, 0, 0, it become e raised to power 0 plus e raised to power 2 pi iota half h half k plus half l, because x, y and z all are 1 by 2. So it becomes e raised to power 0 plus e raised to power iota pi x plus a plus l. 2 is common, 2 say 2 cancel, it becomes e raised to power 0 means 1. So s is 1 plus e raised to power iota pi h plus k plus n. Now according to Fuller's theorem, e raised to power iota theta, e raised to power iota theta is equal to cos theta plus iota sin theta. Okay? So e raised to power iota pi cos pi plus iota sin pi, e raised to power iota 2 pi or 2 pi iota is equal to cos 2 pi plus iota sin 2 pi. And you know sin n pi is always equal to 0, n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. And what is the value of cos pi? Minus 1. Good. Cos pi is minus 1. And what is the value of cos 2 pi? That is 1. That means cos n pi is equal to minus 1 when n is odd. When n is odd. Okay? And cos n pi is equal to 1 when n is even. Cos n pi equal to minus 1 when n is odd and equal to 1 when n is even. So we can write it as cos n pi is equal to minus 1 raised to power n. Minus 1 raised to power n. When n is odd, then it is minus 1. When n is even, it is 1. So we can generalize e raised to power iota n pi, because sin pi is always 0. Sin n pi is always 0. So what left? Cos. If we write e raised to power iota n pi, that become cos n pi, and cos n pi is minus 1 raised to power n. So that means e raised to power iota n pi is minus 1 raised to power n. So remember this. E raised to power iota n pi is equal to minus 1 raised to power n. Now tell me, if h plus k plus l is odd, if sum of these Miller indices is equal to odd number, then it comes out to be minus 1. This value comes out to be minus 1. And 1 minus 1? 0. 1 minus 1? 0. That means if sum of h plus k plus l is odd, then s is 0 for B.Sc. Reflection is not allowed from the plane whose Miller indices, sum of the Miller indices is odd. If sum of the Miller indices is even, then it comes out to be 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So s is 2. That is allowed reflection. is 1 for B.Sc if h plus k plus l sum of the values of Miller indices of a plane is even, then e raised to power iota pi even number, that is 1, so 1 plus 1, 2, so s is 2, that means allowed reflection and is 2 if this h plus k plus l is odd, then e iota pi odd number minus 1, so 1 minus 1 0, so s comes out to be 0, means forbidden reflection. तो फर्स्ट जो था सिंपल क्यूबिक, उसमें कोई भी मिलर इंडिसेस ले लो आप, मिलर प्लेन, ठीक है, उनके लिए रिफ्लेक्शन इज अलाउड. बीसीसी के लिए स्पेसिफिकली दोज प्लेन्स इन विच मिलर इंडिसेस आर सच कि सम ऑफ द वैल्यूज ऑफ मिलर इंडिसेस इज इवन, then reflection is allowed. If it is odd, it is not allowed. The next is S for base centered cubic unit cell. Now, in case of base centered cubic unit cell, what is Z? Z is equal to 4. If Z is 4, what are the coordinates? X, Y, Z. First coordinate is 0, 0, 0. Then half 0. Then half 0, half and 0, half, half. These are the coordinates for the four particles. ये है ना ये पूरा 0, 0, 0, left और left, right तो एक ही था, left, right, एक, फिर bottom, top और front, back, these are the coordinates. Now, derive for S, 0, 0, 0, it become E raised to power 0, second, E raised to power 2 pi iota half h half k, half common आ जाएगा, ठीक है, हो जाएगा iota pi h plus k, क्योंकि इसके लिए 0 हो जाएगा, तो पहला हो गया iota pi h plus k. next half 0 half mean h and l, so yeah, I got e raised to power iota pi h plus l, then iota h plus iota pi h plus l plus e raised to power iota pi k plus, so this is the expression 1 plus iota pi h plus k e raised to power iota pi h plus l e raised to power iota pi k plus. Now listen, if h plus k plus L and K plus L, they are even. If they are even, then it is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1.
4.
Then S is 4. At A L values, if it is equal to, let us take 0, 0, 0. Or we can say even number. Any even number. All are even. Like 2, 2, 2, 2, 0, 0. 0 is taken as even number. Okay? Then 2, 0. Calculate S for these planes. Kitna hai? See. It is 0, 0, 0. Most simple case. 2 plus 0, even. 2 plus 0, 0 plus 2. All are even. That means 4 hai ga. All the sum are even. ठीक है? Even. दूसरा केस लेते हैं. ये है even. All even. अब दूसरा लेते हैं. All odd. That is one one one. In each case, it become even. Odd plus odd is even. Two odd numbers are added, so that become even. That's why, कोई भी आप even number या odd number लोगे, they are allowed. But if it is 1 1 0, that become mixed. Odd and even, then S is equal to 0. So let us take two simple cases. 1, 0, 0, 0. Second, 1, 1, 1. And third, 1, 1, 0. Take three cases. Okay, first case. All even. And now for even we take 0, 0, 0. So S become 1 plus e raised per 0, e raised per 0, e raised per 0. Means k A plus L.
1.
1 plus 0, na? 1. So it is 1. This one is also 1. Even number. These are odd numbers. Minus 1, minus 1. 0. That means orbitals reflection. In case all are even or all are odd, then allowed. So if we derive a rule, selection rule for allowed reflection. Okay, देखो ये सब जो मैंने करवाया है इतना डायरेक्ट डिराइव थोड़ी करोगे वहां जाके. अगर आप कॉम्पिटिटिव में क्वेश्चन कर रहे हो तो ये डिराइव तो मैंने इसलिए करवाया कि ऐसे आता है, ठीक है ना. बाकी तो आपको याद ही रखना है ना. तो सिलेक्शन रूल फॉर अलाउड रिफ्लेक्शन फॉर सिंपल क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल एनी वैल्यू ऑफ HK एंड इन पॉसिबल वैल्यूज ऑफ HK एंड for B.Sc, for B.Sc, H plus K plus L, sum of H plus K plus L should be even. Should be even. If sum is odd, then that is forbidden reflection. याद रखो, याद है 1 plus e raised to the iota pi h plus k plus l. आई अगर आपने अच्छे से समझा होगा ना तो आपको याद ही रह जाएगी क्या, क्योंकि e raised to the 2 by iota था और उसका तो 0 थे तो e की पावर 0 होगी पहले तो 1 हो गया प्लस x y z बाकियों के लिए कितने हाफ 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 आप करोगे तो आप बाहर आ जाएगा 2 पाई ओटा कितना हो जाएगा पाई ओटा h प्लस k प्लस l. कोई ने बोलना यार चुप करके इधर
सिक्वल
क्या बोल allowed. That means for FCC 100 is not allowed. 110, not allowed. 111 is allowed. For simple cubic, 100. लिखता है तो उनका आपको सिंपल क्यूबिक सिंपल क्यूबिक क्वेश्चन बॉडी सेकंड क्यूबिक के सेकंड क्यूबिक 1100 फॉर सिंपल क्यूबिक क्वेश्चन इट इज अलाउड फॉर बीसीसी sum should be equal to even. So sum is odd. 1 plus 0 plus 0 kya ho jayega? Odd. That means it is not allowed. For this case, not allowed. Because all should be even or all should be odd. Okay, ho gaya. Ab aa jao 110. Simple cubic crystal. Is always allowed. BCC? Allowed. Because sum is even. 1 plus 1 plus 0 become even, so it is allowed. All are not odd or even. It is mixed. So, not allowed. For 111? Allowed. BCC? Not allowed. Because sum is odd. Sum is odd. Because all are odd. All are odd. Okay. Even?